In this tutorial, you will learn how to share your screen or portions of it. In this way, you can, for example, share a slide presentation without loading the slides on the whiteboard. You can also demonstrate a software tool such as SolidWorks or SPSS. I click this button to start. This pop-up appears. Notice that it is in three sections. I can share an entire screen, a particular software application that is running on my computer, or any tab currently open in my Chrome web browser. To share your screen, simply click the screen and click the blue Share button. If, as is the case here, the computer has multiple monitors, you can select which one first. If, instead, I choose Application Window, then I will get a list of running programs. I choose one and again click Share. Suppose, for example, I choose Word. This is what it will look like to the participants. Anything I do or type inside the program will appear to them. This is particularly useful if you want to demonstrate how to use a particular piece of software. All you do is share it, and then do whatever procedure you want to demonstrate. And to your students, it will be as if they are looking at your monitor. The third option is to share a tab from your Chrome browser. When you click this option, you get a list of running tabs. For example, I would like to share this tab, which has a Google Slides presentation ready to go. I therefore choose this item from the list and click Share. When I do, my browser goes to full screen, but it's in the presentation area for the students. And when I'm done, I end the sharing by clicking Here. And don't forget to click Here to come back to the main room, of course. There are a few more things worth looking at. See this Actions item over here? When I click it, I get several options, the most important of which involves ending the session. I can choose whether to leave it open until the time runs out, or to end it for all participants when I go. I generally do the latter. And when I do, this is what I see. And that's it for this tutorial. If you haven't done so already, have a look at the first three in this series, and keep your eyes open for others which will be added as needed. And good luck with your classes.